get to school?
Mommy!
Who brought you here to school? Sorry. You all come together. Together.
Good to meet you. I'm Koh Poh Koon. Thanks. Hope you will support us so we can help to make life better for everyone in Punggol East.
Yeah. How do you plan to do that?
Well, I think the first thing is childcare is one thing that we want to look into because there's probably a huge demand here. Yeah. So in the next few months ahead, we will really look at seriously increasing the capacity. But I think the plans do need to take into account like stakeholders, like parents, what you all want, what you all like. Because there's no point you put things that is not useful to you. So we do want to engage people first and get a sense of what is important and so that it's relevant to all of you. Because ultimately, it's about putting things in place in a community that is of use to you. So things like logistic challenges and maybe capacity issues, we will look into that. I have two young children myself, so I perfectly understand. One is 9, the other one is 4. Oh. So I know the challenges of primary school, and I can feel the pain of trying to keep a young one in a childcare, because if we don't put them in childcare, it's very hard for us to go to work.
Yeah, you know?
And then after they finish childcare, somebody has to go and pick them up. Yeah, so all these logistic challenges are not easy. I mean, my wife is amazing. I mean, because I work long hours, and sometimes she
takes... working or?
She's working, and even then she has to, you know, juggle with taking care of the two kids. So I can understand that working women like her, you know, some of the challenges are quite formidable. Sudah makan?
Sudah.
Okay. Boleh vote for PAP.
Okay.
Give us a chance to serve you.
Okay.
Okay. Terima kasih.
Sama.
Terima kasih. Well, I prefer to have a personal touch when it comes to meeting with residents. I prefer to interact with them personally. And of course, we have people who are also helping to distribute the flyers. But my preference is always to have a chance to listen, to appreciate, empathize, and then also have a chance to communicate with them. So I prefer to be actually knocking on the doors myself. Yeah, I think in order to understand residents' problems and their needs, the most important thing is to start listening and to begin to empathize with the problem. Because until we can understand where the needs are, it's very difficult to prescribe solution. Jumping to solutioning is always easy, because you can always think of a lot of solutions, but it may not be appropriate, it may not be exactly be what people need. It's much like doctoring, you need to take a good history, listening to the patients first, before you start to prescribe treatment. No, I think the residents are still always concerned about day-to-day things. I mean, some of the things that surface would be things like localized issues like childcare, how many childcare centres they have here, and how do they, you know, get enough places to eat, for example. These are all very local issues. Some blocks have bird problems, bird that goes into their houses. I wouldn't say this is a national problem when it comes to birds flying into the houses. So it is these little things that actually makes life a bit difficult and quite uncomfortable. So I think talking and listening to them, I get a good sense that most of the things that preoccupy them are very much local. Yeah, I mean, these things will have to be tackled, but I think more importantly, we can solve the immediate local issues that will make life quite much more bearable, at least in the short term. Like I said, I prefer to make sure that I touch base with the residents, hear their problems and solve their problems, which is why I feel that at the end of the day, as long as I can solve their problems, the residents will come begin to appreciate what we can do for them.
With childcare, you actually need a more national kind
which is why if I get into parliament, I will be raising these issues as well to try and champion for more to be done in this area. I think anything that relates to family will be something of concern. People with young family like mine, struggling with children going to school, working mothers, these are all issues that are close to my heart. I think in a generic sense, everybody who has children face similar needs. I don't think there's anything particularly special about minority that is different from the rest. I think as long as we're all Singaporeans, we all face similar challenges. But of course, there are certain things that if they have, we can also continue to address. I think I think it's fairly well distributed. Most people are generally quite warm. Of course, they all have slightly different concerns. But I would say aunties are usually a little bit warmer than usual anyway. Well, I think she has to weigh whatever proposal she thinks to be appropriate. For me, I prefer to study the problems first, engage the stakeholders, understand what really works for them before we roll out something. I mean, when we talk to some residents, some of these things, they will raise the issue of cost of transportation as well. So having more feeder services may not solve the other problems if the residents are unwilling to take them.